Good morning, everyone. Today is April 29, and we find ourselves in John 6:63, going back to our devotional. John 6:63, it is the Spirit that quickeneth. The words that I speak unto you, they are spirit and they are life. Title of today's devotion is Demonstrate Your Faith. Demonstrate Your Faith. Ito po ang sabi ni A.W. Tozer. We know of many who have been deceived into believing that the learning and the memorizing of Christian doctrine is all sufficient. They actually think that somehow they are better off for having learned the doctrines of religion. Maganda yung sinabi niya rito. Just because you know doctrines, that doesn't mean that you are okay or you're saved. Right? Many in the time of Jesus Christ knew doctrines, the Pharisees, yet they were blind to the truth that everything that they were reading about, everything that they know about, everything that they memorized about is pointing to Christ. Pero nagbulag-bulagan sila. Therefore, they are not indeed saved. Tasabi rito ni Tozer, God actually asks of us what he asked of Noah long ago. Demonstrate your faith in God in your everyday life. It is evident that God did not say to Noah, I'm depending on you to hold... Thank you, Cleo, for stopping. I'm depending on you to hold the proper orthodox doctrines. Everything will be just fine if you stand up for the right doctrines. No, God did not tell Noah that. Noah was asked to demonstrate his faith in God every day. Right? I have read a statement by Martin Lloyd-Jones, the English preacher and writer, in which he said, it is perilously close to being sinful for any person to learn doctrine for doctrine's sake. Maganda yon. It's dangerous to be knowing or to be studying doctrine for doctrine's sake. Many today know doctrines and try to memorize doctrines. Para saan? Is it for them to get closer to God? Is it for them to know more about God? And because God is, they desire? No, some of them try to study doctrine and know doctrine, pero para lamang doon, para lang ipakit nila sa mga tao that they know doctrines. But don't get me wrong, doctrines are important, right? Doctrines basically are truth, teachings by God from His Word. Pero the teachings of God should translate into a demonstration of those teachings applied to our lives, right? Importante po yun. Doctrine cannot save us. Doctrine is very important, but the one who truly is saved would desire to know more about God, to know doctrine. Para saan? Para alam niya kung paano niya mas mapupurihan ang kanyang Diyos. So that he would know how God is glorified and how God desires to be worshipped. Ito po ang kaibahan nung ilan sa panahon natin ngayon. In fact, panahon noon hanggang ngayon, who study doctrine just for doctrine's sake. Who study doctrine kasi gusto lang nilang may image sila na marami silang alam doctrines. Pero don't get me wrong, the other flip side is all the same dangerous. Those who don't wanna be learning doctrines, who don't want to be memorizing great truths about God, is just the same perilous, just the same dangerous. Kasi bakit? Anong katotohanan ay sa buhay mo? Right? Anong katuruan ng Diyos ang i-demonstrate mo kung hindi mo ito alam? So there should be a good balance of knowing doctrines and living out these doctrines for whose sake? Not for our sake, but for God's glory's sake. For us to be pointing people to Him as the one who is truth and the one who is grace, right? Ano pa sabi rito ni Tozer? I agree with his conclusion. Yung conclusion na sinabi ni Martin Lloyd-Jones na it is perilously close to being sinful for any person to learn doctrine for doctrine's sake. Sabi ni Tozer, I agree with his conclusion that doctrine is always best when it is incarnated. Alright, ganda, no? You know what the best doctrine is? The best doctrines are those that are being applied to our lives. When it is seen fleshed out in the lives of godly men and women, our God Himself appeared at His very best when He came into our world and lived in our flesh. And I say amen to that. Again, we desire doctrines. We love doctrines. We love truth. We love scripture. But we ought to be living these truths out. Not for our sake, but for God's glory's sake. Let's listen to the prayer of Tozer for us. Dear Lord, enable me to demonstrate my faith in practical ways today. Remind me to put feet to my faith when I have the inclination to hide my light under a stack of hay. Again, that is a beautiful reminder for all of us to desire truth, but to desire those truths lived out para sa kapurihan ng ating Panginoong Diyos. Right? Very important po ang truth. Very important. Otherwise, we would not know how to please God, right? And we would not know more about God because we want to know Him, di ba? Para mas mapalapit tayo ang puso natin sa Kanya, para mas maunawaan natin siya, para mas alam natin kung ano ang kapuri-puri sa Kanya. But these truths that we know, learn, study, and memorize should be translated into into righteous living, into lives desiring to honor Him sa lahat ng aspeto ng ating buhay. Right? So, napakagandang paalala muli sa atin ng ating Panginoon Diyos. Manalangin po tayo. Lord, we thank You for this beautiful reminder that indeed Your truth is very important. That doctrines, Your objective truth, wonderful and timeless truths, Lord, from Your Word are very important. But Lord, we pray that we would not be studying them just for the sake of studying them. Search our hearts, O God. Sana po hindi kami nag-aaral ng Biblia para lang sa isipin ng maraming tao, marami kaming alam tungkol sa Biblia. Sana po hindi self-serving ang aming pag-aaral. Sana po hindi po para sa aming sariling kapurihan, para bumilib sa aming mga tao, kaya kami nag-aaral lang niyo pong salita. Ang dalangin namin, Lord, we would be found wanting to know more about You and to know more of You in Your Word, because we desire to serve You more, we desire to love You more, and we desire, Lord, to share You to the people around us, especially yung mga taong pinagkatiwala niyo po sa amin. Thank You, Lord, for this beautiful reminder that it is just the same dangerous kung kami po ay maraming alam na katotohanan, subalit hindi namin sinasabuhay. Thank You for reminding us that swinging to the other side of the pendulum, not knowing and not desiring truth at all, is just the same dangerous. Give us a good balance, Lord, of being in the truth, being in Your grace. Marami pong salamat muli sa panahon na ito na inyo pong kino-comfort kami at in-encourage kami sa inyong salita. We pray, Lord, that as we go through this pandemic, Lord, hindi namin po alam kung hanggang kailan ito matatapos, but we trust in You that You would protect us, that You would protect our loved ones, that You would just be with all of us. We pray that we would be found people of truth and people who practice these truths, Lord, for Your glory's sake. Maraming salamat pong muli. Kayo po na mapapurihan sa araw na ito and in the rest of the week. Maraming pong salamat sa pangalan mo, Jesus. Amen. Thanks for joining me. Sana po okay kayong lahat. Sana hindi kayo masyadong depressed or discouraged. If you are discouraged, open your Bibles. and be encouraged by God's truth. If you want to hear God's word audibly, read your Bibles out loud, right? Sige po, ingat kayo, and I'll see you all tomorrow. God bless you.